who we are. Just I'm going to cover a little bit about who we are. We are the four offices in the worldwide, and then we work the 6 continental and more than 50 countries. We have offices in New York, and then one is Mumbai and Shanghai, Hong Kong. And we are fast 50 years. We have a number of projects from starting with World Trade Center, and then today we have Bank of China and then Bitex Tower. And these are the couple of projects in India. Especially we about to complete almost all of them topped up. So World Towers, and then we have a Worli 360 West. And these are the other couple of other projects. So this is one of the project, M3M Gurgaon. So this is the one SRM Satsang Mall. This is a special, it is a covers under the it's a devotional place. So it was a different project we had here. The another Radisson Hotel here, many people have seen. It is also topped up. We have given our schematic service. These are the very few projects we have completed projects. My presentations like covers more, as I said, like it going to be cover the composite constructions in the building which we are talking about. So what is about the composite steel design? I want to just, this many people have known this one, but there has a undergone, like there is a very good benefits are there when you see the composite. As a steel, I would not prefer, because as a steel, a material with a composite action, it gives a blended benefits. Say use of the efficiency, use of the material with the concrete and steel is a composite construction. And this gives the very good fall ceiling. We don't require, as Mr. Ronak mentioned, you can't see any props there at the site, because it's giving the steel beams, and then your deck is giving a fall, kind of a propping, the shuttering system, which doesn't require anything. And it also acts as a fall ceiling end of the day. It's a permanent fall ceiling. And then it will give the sustainable construction and the lightweight flooring system, and it will also give the faster construction, which also can use for the columns, of course. So this is a few views how it looks, the composite floor construction. So this is a sample floor cross section. When you say office building, how the like composite cross section and the steel beam, that we can get it, the sample of it. You can see the right side picture, that we can make the section can be a lesser depth to accommodate the services and etc. Like as you mentioned, most of the things are covered in the last slides. These are the, we have fast experience, very few projects of the Bank of China Tower, which was the first outside the Chicago and then New York, maybe the first composite construction executed in the world. So this achieved a tremendous cost benefit because of this adoption of the composite construction. Coming to the latest one, we have worked at the World Trade Center, Tower 4. So these are the building parameters. As mentioned, I have not need to go through them. Each and every point is already covered. So coming to the structural systems, in this building, we have a gravity system, like everything is covered with a composite steel construction, flooring and as well as the columns. That is one of the factors we could able to achieve the lesser area of the lesser size of the columns, with a more achievable carpet area. So it is also fast in terms of the floor construction would be, I'll be going to discuss more about this gravity system. Coming to the ladder system, and then foundation basement walls covered in the RCC. So this is the most interesting and as well as challenging thing for us to make it this project happening. First thing we have tried, as Mr. J mentioned in his slides, we have tried with the different grids, concrete and steel option. So the first 8x8 grid was there proposed, and then we worked out the steel option. I didn't cover the concrete options, but here we got a maximum depth of 610 mm. So again, we thought, like, you know, 8 to 9 meters can be nowadays flat slab system with the drop panel can be easily worked out. Why we have to go to steel? So, and also it is like slightly, it is become expensive when compared to the concrete with the same concrete option with the flat slab system. Then we we reworked it and we made 8 by 12, and then the 12 meters was the filler beams. But if you use the earlier options here, everything like filler beam and girders are 8 by 8 grid. That giving nothing advantage for the filler beams. When you make the filler beams a larger spans, one direction of the building, it covers like 12 meters, we stretched it. This is the one thing like, you know, give more or less uniform depth for the filler beam and girders, because girder beam depth is almost same span is there. And of course, this can be only achievable properly by providing the propping to the like filler beams, or maybe cambering, we have to adapt it. It's not the same depth we cannot able to achieve without that. So here the big advantages are, here we have increased the column free space, and then also minimize the number of pieces, which would be almost 40 to 50%. We reduce the number of pieces and the saving of the craning time. If your number of pieces are more, your construction going to take time, and then crane activities are important. Right now they have proposed two cranes, but which like compared to earlier piece, if you go for the pieces this year, it will take almost double time to take the crane usage for the number of pieces. And this also subsequently lead the faster connection, lesser connections to the member. So this is the typical podium floor layout. So we have reduced the spans here because of your podium floor height is only, we have approximately 3 to 3.3 meters high. I think we need to have the lesser depth of the beam, so that is the reason we have to add the in-between columns. This also subsequently reduce the column sizes for the tower areas. So here is a big small comparison with the RCC and composite steel comparison. If you see orally, the gravity load self weight of the structure is reduced compared to the RCC, because that subsequently earthquake loads will be reducing, your foundations loads also reducing, your, as I mentioned the last time, number of pieces we reduce, the speed of construction is also reduced. Composite construction itself, it is a less time taking because you don't have much to do as compared to the RCC for the construction wise, proppings and etc. So of course we have a lot of flexibility for the tenants who are coming occupied. We can have more like, you know, we can make arrangements for the MEP sleeves or opening cutouts, and then we can able to achieve the same time larger spans. If you go with the normal RCC or a flat slab system, would they typically 8 to 9 meters we can do it, but the same thing can be achieved 12 meters for the composite beam. So of course we can do with the PT, but that is again, it's a time dependent cost, construction and cost also. There's a 2 points I brought it here as a pitfall, but I would not say it is like, you know, major drawbacks, because it's a ceiling height, we have to be made little more careful about that when we are using the composite construction. And materials, construction materials, maybe contractor would know better. I think this point, it is a lead time which the major, like a bigger contractors, they can able to overcome this spot. So the lateral system, resisting system, we have a shear walls. As this is a good advantage when adopting the shear wall system for this building, because the core can go climb with the self climbing formwork, so which can be a 2-3 levels difference compared to the steel construction floor gravity construction. So this is the advantage, this is the future of the steel, I would say, advantages of high performance steel. So when you talk about the steel, right now we are using a E250 and 350, but now the world is like moving ahead, they have started using the 800 grade also. That we are like recently, past 1 or 2 years, we are working with the POSCO. This is the one of the large biggest producer for the steel. So they are making the higher grade, high strength grade steels, which can be, if you see compared today, I mean, we are using 350, but if you compare with the 400, your section size will be drastically reducing. 50% you can see that results. So this will subsequently helpful for the steel tonnage, welding cost, connection, everything, individual pieces, lifting as I mentioned. So that you will get on the more carpet area because you have a lot of strength in the steel, which column size is tremendously reducing. So a lot of benefits are there.